right, studio audience, deep breath in anticipation for our next guest.
These guest introductions are a great excuse to talk someone up. But really, if I just said the words Zac Efron, you know you would all just start to scream. Hard to believe it's only been 6 years since High School Musical first propelled Zac to superstardom. And since then, we've watched his body of, work go from strength to strength. His latest is The Lucky One, which also features rising star Taylor Schilling.
I promised myself that if I made it out, I would find that girl and thank her for saving my life.
Both are in the country to promote the film, again, causing people to...
Welcome Zac Efron and Taylor Schilling! One we've had. That is great. First off, just welcome. Great to have you on the project. Love the movie. Zac, starting with you, am I right? This is your 8th time in Australia?
It's getting up there. Yeah, I got to be close to 10.
Have you got like a weird contract? Why do you keep coming back? Like, what is it?
Yeah, I'm getting paid. I just love it, man. Every time I come, I have a great time. I'm lucky I have a lot of fans out here. So, actually, we were lucky enough this time to have the world premiere of The Lucky One here in Australia.
Yep, so is Zac being a good host? Obviously, he'd be able to show you around.
He has so many ideas, so many things that he wants to do.
One idea? What have you guys done?
Do you want to climb a bridge?
Tim Tams!
Have you drunk? You need to drink some tea through a Tim Tam.
What?
Yeah. By the corner
of
the
corner. You didn't tell me about that.
That's another idea. A new idea.
It's really important you have to bite opposite corners off, otherwise you get no fluid movement whatsoever. So you have to, that's very important. Now, with the film, Zac, seen you sing, seen you dance, very, like, cheerful characters along the way, but you play a returned vet. This is a much more serious role for you.
It was a much more mature role than I've ever played before, but it was awesome. I basically got to go to Marine school with the pretty intense training, and I think we made a fantastic movie.
How did they treat you at Marine school? I mean, you were, you're a handsome young man and who loves to dance. Were they tough on you or not?
Yeah, just extrapolate. Yeah. No, you know what? It was tough, man. Yeah. It's a character that's very far from who I am personally. So I knew I was going to get jabbed at, but I ended up having a pretty good time with those guys.
There's a lot of chemistry. Hey. There's a lot of chemistry in the film between you guys. Yeah. You know, when the cameras aren't rolling, did you become good mates during the filming?
We did. I knew she was going to do that. I was wondering if I should go for the same joke.
That's very kind of you.
We did, yeah, we did.
We did. We spent a lot of time together. I had never been to New Orleans either, so Zac kind of showed me around.
He's taking you to a lot of places.
I know. Expanding my horizon.
Did you eat Tim Tams in New Orleans?
No, but I ate alligator.
Oh, really? Impressive.
Really. I know. You look so concerned. I was concerned, too.
Alligators are dangerous.
I know.
It was dead.
Are they is alligator tasty?
They tasted like chicken.
It's like chicken.
Yeah.
Everything's like chicken, isn't it?
Yeah.
So Charlie tells me that the love scene is very, very hot. Well done,
so
you guys.
So Charlie said.
What was it like to film?
It was pretty rad.
It was pretty rad.
Well, we had a great time. Like, at that point in the filming, we were lucky enough, actually, Scott Hicks.
Who's an Aussie,
our director. We shot the movie sort of in order. The big chunks of the movie, the important scenes, were all done kind of in order. So at this point, the love scene was well-deserved, and we knew each other
You'd done enough flirting, basically.
How do they actually decide at what point in a love scene to stop it? Do they blow a whistle? Do they just turn on a hose? Like, what's the approach in that situation?
That's actually a good question. How did it end?
It was kind of what I mean.
Zac, I've just put on 9 kilos for this baby that I'm about to have. And I hear you've put on, mine's mostly ice cream and baby weight. But I understand you've put on 9 kilos as well, but it's all muscle. How'd you do it?
It was a pretty intense training process. Man, I wish I could just eat ice cream. and do it. That'd be amazing. I trained every day with the Navy SEAL, and it was a pretty grueling training process. And then on top of that, just had to eat a ton of calories, all healthy calories.
No Tim Tams.
No Tim Tams.
Did I hear Tim right that you got so sick of like chicken breasts, you made a chicken shake? Is that right?
Oh, that's wrong.
Yeah, it's not that bad.
It's not that bad.
It really wasn't that bad.
With milk, or what do you put it with?
Milk.
We got to add it with something to make a smoothie.
Chewing the chicken was the hardest thing. I tell you what, I would drink a chicken shake over chewing, five chicken breasts a day.
Chewing the chicken was the hardest thing you did.
It was. That and the love scene. It was really. It's not the amount that you have to eat. It's just the chewing of it. It would take forever. Really, I had to work. I had to like film scenes. Yeah. You know,
any kids out there that think being a big Hollywood film star is easy? Listen to Zac. It's tough. Yeah, you have to chew your food. That is tough.
Have we just rolled that package before? You were laughing when you saw yourself the High School Musical days. Does that just feel like a whole world ago?
It kind of does now. It kind of does. It just makes me laugh because. I imagine why it makes me laugh. it was so much fun. I just look like I'm 15. Well,
footage of anyone at school makes them laugh. You should see me at school. Taylor, you would have been gorgeous at school, though. There's no doubt about that.
I just think the audience admired your plot. I think that's all.
Well, the lucky one is out April 19. Zac Efron, Taylor Schilling, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you very much.